Hi everybody, today is April 27th, 2013. Massive uncontained leak at Fukushima is pouring over 710 billion becquerels of radioactive materials into the atmosphere. And this comes from naturalnews.com. The tsunami caused nuclear accident at the Fukushima power station. In Japan is the disaster that never ends. As new reports indicate that a wealth of new radioactive materials have been spewing into the atmosphere. According to Singapore-based news outlet Asia One, the Tokyo Electric Power Company, TEPCO, which owns the multi-nuclear reactor power station at Fukushima, announced April 6 that some 120 tons of water that had been contaminated with radioactive substances had leaked from an underground storage facility at the number one atomic power plant site. Running out of storage room? TEPCO officials announced the leak late. Got that late in the day, April 5th on Friday. Now, government often releases information on Friday because no one watches the news on Friday. But said measures to address the problem had not been taken for 2 days because the cause had not been identified. Asia One reported, the company assumed the water was still leaking. That's what I heard. 400 tons of water is leaking every day into the ground soil. According to company officials, TEPCO estimates that the leaked water contains about 710 billion becquerels of radioactive substances, making it the largest leak of radioactive material ever at the plant. Discovery of the leak led the companies to transfer about 13,000 tons of polluted radioactive water in the questionable storage area to a neighboring underground storage unit. That storage unit, TEPCO said, is 60 meters long, 53 meters wide, and 6 meters deep. It is pool-like in structure and has a three-layer waterproof sheet with a concrete cover. According to the company, water that has leaked from damaged nuclear reactors is run through filters and additional devices in order to remove radioactive elements. Well, evidently they don't get it all, not even close. The water is then stored in facilities for low-level contaminated water. TEPCO began using the storage facility February 1st. As of April 5th, 13,000 tons of radioactive water was being stored there, very close to the 14,000-ton limit. It should be noted, too, that these filters to take out their radioactive elements came from Russia, I believe. More leaking contamination. Asia One reported that water samples taken by TEPCO from soil surrounding the damaged facility a few days later showed 35 becquerels per cubic centimeter of radioactive substances, which is abnormal. Safe levels, and actually there's no such thing as safe levels, of becquerels is 300 per kilogram of water, according to New Scientist. However, TEPCO officials did not publicly announce their findings right away. No, they waited until Friday. After not finding any other unusual changes in water quality data, such as chlorine concentration. Now, why would they be testing for chlorine? Chlorine would come from water that's been processed, like drinking water. On April 5th, report said 2 days after the problem was first noticed, water with 6,000 becquerels per cubic centimeter of radioactive substances was located between the first and second layers of the waterproof sheet, which alerted TEPCO engineers and plant officials that a leak had occurred. Now, Asia One says that as the sheet layers were joined when the facility was constructed, TEPCO assumed that the sheet may have been damaged or that a mistake had been done during construction. An average of 400 tons a day of groundwater seeping into buildings housing nuclear reactors and turbines, increasing the quantity of polluted water. Now, that's a day. 400 tons a day is leaking. Now, it gives you an indication it's going from the storage facility and then into the nuclear reactors and turbines. The latest problem will create a storage shortage. TEPCO officials said storage of polluted water at the facility will be reduced from 53,000 tons to 40,000 tons, a significant reduction. That will make it necessary for the power company to go over procedures for handling polluted water, which will include increasing the number of storage units. As the height of water storage facility is relatively low, and that's a lie, we think it's unlikely that the polluted water mixed into underground water and reached the sea 800 meters away. And that's a lie, too. The acting chief of TEPCO's nuclear facility department at a press conference said April 6th. The plant was damaged by a huge earthquake-caused tsunami March 11th. The plant was already in meltdown when the earthquake occurred. The employees ran from the facility even before the tsunami hit because of the damage to the nuclear reactors. At the time of the incident, three of the plant's atomic reactors were shut down. Number 4 had been defueled, and number 5 and 6 were in cold shutdown for maintenance. The remaining 3 automatically shut down at the time of the accident, and emergency generators came on to keep coolant systems operating. That's a lie, too. The emergency generators were flooded and with the tsunami and never worked. Not once. Big lies. Lots of lies. And it takes hours for plants to go into shutdown, and the tsunami came within minutes. The NRC came out with a report just recently that I reported about, saying how TEPCO is really downplaying how long it's going to take to decommission this plant. TEPCO says 40 years, which means 40 years all this radiation is going to be leaking into the environment, the water, the ocean, the air. The NRC says it's going to take much, much longer than 40 years. And they also said they need to upgrade their equipment instead of using stuff that doesn't work. Basically, what their report said was baling wire and duct tape just doesn't cut it. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.